Hello and welcome to theCUBE's coverage of AWS reInvent 2025. I'm Rob Strechay and we're talking about all things agentic and AI, which has been all the talk here in Las Vegas. To help me break this down and what is needed to build an infrastructure to support agents at scale, let me bring in Han Xiao, who's the Vice President of AI at Elastic and founder and former CEO of Jina AI. Welcome on board, Han.
Thanks, Rob.
So before we dive in too deep here, help us understand Jina AI, what your goals were before the acquisition by Elastic and what it's really about.
Yeah. So Jina AI was founded in 2020. So our only goal is to build a world-class search model. So we call them the search foundation models. So that particularly includes the embeddings, rerankers, and the small language models that people can use to build better search system, high quality search system, and high relevance search system. And so over the last 5 years, we have been extensively working on building the world-class model, make sure that they work on multilingual, multimodal data, and that they can be used as a foundational building block when people try to build a highly scalable and highly accurate search system.
Yeah, I think that makes a lot of sense when you start to look at what is going on with AI and what is going on in this entire realm. It's so busy. What did the acquisition really mean to Elastic? And what does it really underscore for Elastic as well?
Yeah. So one of the observations that we look at is when people try to build a very high quality search system, they typically need a lot of building block. And they also need an orchestration layer, which basically connects all the dots together. Elastic, and in particular the Elasticsearch, is one of the most downloaded and usable framework for developers and business to build production-ready system, search system. So we want to be the computational layer behind this search system, right? So we want to use our embedding models to better represent all this document data, image data, multimodal data into vector representation so that people can leverage semantic search vector database to query those data, get those data more accurately. And then we also have a ranker model, which basically serve as another computational block, happens after the first stage retrieval. So this basically boosts the accuracy and precision even further. So finally, when you think about today's agentic AI, so there always be a large language model on, as it happens at the last stage, which basically generates the answers and optimize the search result. For that, we are also providing some small language model to help the agent better understand the context and output more meaningful and more human readable search result.
So Han, help me understand how, you know, bringing Jina to Elastic is really helping out in the ecosystem.
So right now, for developers and business to build a high quality search system, you need not only the orchestration layer, not only the framework, but also you need the brain behind this framework. And who is going to provide this brain? Right. So basically, at Jina, we have spent years of research and development on building the best search model that can be plugged in into any search system. And so this particular is useful when in today's world, when you try to handle multimodal data and multilingual data, where there are a lot of things that cannot be implemented using traditional keyword-based search, right? So in this case, where Jina models, in particular those deep neural network-based models, are really helpful when they can better represent those multimodal data into a searchable format.
Yeah, that to me is so important to organizations as they look at having that control plane for their agentic operating system, you know, which is these applications, which are multimodal in many ways. but you also talk about context engineering. Kind of help us understand where Jina's AI team has really been pushing with that whole space as well.
Yeah, so context engineering is a very heated topic today. So a lot of people talk about context engineering and how important they are in the search and any agentic system. So to me, like context engineering is all about cherry picking what are the best words that you need to send to the LLM before it answers, before it emits the output. It sounds very simple, right? So you basically try to selectively copy the context and into LLM. But in reality, there are a lot of technical details. For example, how do you preserve the information while reducing the total number of tokens in the context? How do you rank different search results in the context so that LLM can recognize which snippet is more important to the answers? And how do you mask out the personal sensitive information before sending to the LLM API? So those kind of things basically fall into the context engineering category. To that, we actually have a lot of small language models, which basically can be very, very useful for those context engineering purposes. For example, one can use embedding model to compress the context by preserving the information overall. One can use reranker to re-rank the number of passages to compute the optimal passages and put them on the top of the context so that LLM gives them more emphasis in the answers. So I think in general, this is a very, very exciting time for small language models to be shine in this context engineering domain. So one of the observations that I see over the last 1 year is that originally those embeddings models and reranker models are built for large scale purpose, right? So they're built in the way that they can batch process billions of documents, and they are used as the kind of the core retriever behind the search system. But since 2025, what I see is a lot of embeddings and reranker usage happens inside the context, inside this 1 million context length of the large language models. And I believe these trends will continue in the next year, in 2026. And we will see that, so people will look for more strong and smarter small language model that can be used to optimize the context in a very extreme way so that the large language model can give much, much better results.
Totally agree. I think that, again, it talks to the whole fact of specificity of a small language model and how it can really help with particular tasks as you build it out. Kind of help us, here understand the context of Jina with ELSER and the Elastic Inference Service and what it means going forward with Elastic.
So Elastic Inference Service is right now the default inference service that behind all the Elastic Search System. When developer try to use embedding service, reranker service, or any audience small language model, they are basically underneath, they are calling the ELSER or what we call the Elastic Inference Service underneath. So from now on, Jina is going to be the default model provider for ELSER. And so developer can have very handy experience to access all the top models from Jina AI. But also ELSER will stay open. So basically not only Jina AI model, but also other very strong embeddings ranker models, they will also be appear on ELSER. And what we want to provide is the best developer experience for all the business to make sure that they have the immediate access every time there's a new embedding model, new reranker model, new small language model that can be used to build the search system.
That makes so total sense. And I think it fits in very well with what everybody is trying to do at reInvent this year as they look towards building out these agentic workflows and how they are able to bring different types of data and different types of actions together. And you know, again, I think that makes a lot of sense. So, hey, Han, thank you for coming on board. This has been great. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Rob. Yeah.
And thank you for watching.